What is up, folks? Welcome to another edition of Billy the Kid's No Bullshit Toy Reviews. Today, we are taking a look at Transformers Kingdom Leader Class Optimus Prime. Now, I know I've reviewed the Earthrise Optimus Prime, but I felt, you know what? They're giving us a new Prime in package. Is it any different? Is it worth your money? And I'll tell you right off the bat, it is the same figure. I know some pictures have come up that state that these points at the top are thinner. Unfortunately, I don't have a Earthrise copy anymore. That was lent to me by Nick at Big Tin Robot Toys and Collectibles, so I'm not going to be able to compare them. He comes with his classic blaster, and he comes with a card pack-in. So that's the back. This is the front, and what you do is you peel off to reveal which version of Black Arachne it is. Now, this one is the Autobot version, and they actually have it painted up in her Transmetal 2 colors. So I'm wondering, will we get a repaint? It's pretty rad. I'm cool with that. So the trailer opens up and becomes his repair bay. This piece here is articulated up, down, full left, right, 360. It's on a peg, so it's really whatever you can do with it. This rotates up. This rotates as well. Arms are on a single ball peg. Okay, so, you know, 360 degrees and a little bit of in and out. But nothing to write home about. Optimus Prime, on the other hand, is beautiful. Easily the best modern Optimus Prime we've ever gotten. His gun plugs right into his hand, holds it just fine, no looseness. The tolerances on this figure are fantastic, especially being a reuse of the previous mold. You would think there'd be a little bit of, you know, looseness, but it's not there. Hands are painted blue to match the colors on Optimus Prime as they were originally molded in gray. So, his chest opens up as well to reveal a Matrix of Leadership. This is the exact same Matrix of Leadership that comes with Studio Series Hot Rod. So if you have him, that Matrix Burst effect will connect and will work. Head is on a ball joint, looks up, looks down, full 360 degrees. You've got rotation at the shoulder, full 360 degrees, and he comes up this much. You've also got a bicep swivel, and you've got a bend at the elbow for around 90 degrees. Wrist rotation, thumb is stationary, all fingers are on a shared pinned knuckle, but you do get motion in the hands. You've got a waist swivel where if you, let's say you do dynamic posing, you can bring that down and it'll give you the 360 degree freedom that you're looking for. If not, it's a little limited, but it's more than enough in my opinion. Full Van Damme kicks up this far, kicks back this far, excellent bend at the knee, toes tilt, toes go down. Very poseable. Like I said, he's got to be the best modern Optimus Prime we've ever gotten. You really can't go wrong with him. Now, the only figure I have available for a size comparison at the moment is Studio Series Hot Rod, and I think they look really good together. I think that you really can't go wrong. That if you missed out on Earthrise Optimus Prime, you should absolutely pick up Kingdom. It is a wonderful figure. I'm going to get him into vehicle mode, and we'll talk about that next. Here we have Transformers Kingdom Optimus Prime in his vehicle mode. Just like his robot mode, it is no different than the Earthrise Optimus Prime. It is the same toy. So, rolls just fine. Looks good from the front view. Looks okay from the side view. I still think that they could have added the stabilizers underneath, as well as a wheel well here to really finish it off. Back of the trailer. Now, I do like, though, that inside of his trailer is weapon storage. So that's nice. You don't have to plug his gun into the side of his vehicle mode. But all in all, I think it's a nice Optimus Prime. It's definitely the best mainline Optimus Prime that we've gotten in years. I mean, he's right up there with the original Classics Voyager, which many thought for a long time that that was the best Optimus Prime we'd ever get. The only real complaint I have, I have two complaints with him in vehicle mode. I have three complaints, actually. First, this trailer could have been bigger, just a little bit. Didn't have to be a lot bigger, but it definitely could have been bigger. It just feels improperly scaled with his cab over. My gripes are these gas tanks, if you so much as touch them, they fold right back in. So that's a little cheap in my mind. And this gap, I know that there's some sets out there that'll fill it, but they definitely could have done something to fill that gap up. But other than that, excellent. I like him a lot. Kudos to Hasbro on the new boxes. You guys really stepped it up. I love the fact that there's not as much plastic. You're going to make the recycling a lot easier. So kudos for going green. As always, check out my sponsors, Big Tin Robot Toys and Collectibles, down in the link below. If you like what you see, please give me a like and subscribe to my Patreons. Thank you so much for your continued support and belief in my channel. You guys really make it all worthwhile. This is Billy the Kid signing off.